Today topic is how IGBT based rectifier works in VFD or VVVF. VFD means variable frequency drive. VVVF means variable voltage, variable frequency. Means voltage and frequency both are controlled here. This is block diagram of VFD. This is single phase AC input. This is inductor. This is IGBT based rectifier which convert AC into DC. This is DC link, capacitor. And this is IGBT based three phase inverter which convert DC into three phase output. Here voltage and frequency both are controlled. This is detailed circuit of this IGBT based rectifier. Before I explain detail of this circuit, I will tell you one concept. After knowing that, you can understand the function of the circuit very easily. Here I will explain the concept how IGBT can charge the capacitor. This is simple circuit, AC supply, inductor. This IGBT I have shown here as a simple switch. This is diode, capacitor and a load. These are three plots. This shows the on off of this IGBT. On off status. This shows the source current or inductor current, IS. And this plot shows the VC, voltage across capacitor. In the beginning, this IGBT is open. Now if this is positive, current will flow like this and this capacitor will be charged. Function of IGBT will start after this capacitor has been charged. Now suppose at this point, I will switch on this IGBT. From here to here, IGBT is on. When IGBT is on, there is a short circuit here. So current in this reactor will start increasing. So this IS is increasing. During this period, load will take the current from this capacitor and capacitor will discharge. Here, discharging. So current is increasing, capacitor is discharging. At this point, we will switch off this IGBT. Now this switch is open. Now inductor has stored the energy. Current was flowing like this. Current cannot become zero immediately because of this inductor energy. So current will flow like this now because there is no path here. So this IS will flow like this. This capacitor will charge when switch is open. So this capacitor will start charging and this current IS will reduce because this energy will transfer to the capacitor. So during half period, this capacitor will charge and this current will reduce. At this point, we will switch on IGBT again. As soon as we switch on the IGBT again, current will flow like this and current in this will start increasing. IS will increase and this capacitor will start discharging because it has to supply the current to the load. So this way we will go on doing on off and we can transfer the inductor energy into capacitor energy and capacitor voltage will be something like this. This is detailed circuit of IGBT based rectifier. This is AC supply and this is inductor. We are using 4 numbers of IGBT, 1, 2, 3, 4. And every IGBT has one diode in parallel. Current in the diode will be like this. Current in the IGBT will be like this. This IGBT I have shown as a simple switch. Here, this is the current flowing IS at incomer. And this is VC, voltage across this capacitor. This is load. In fact, this load will not be here. I have shown here, this will be after inverter. This is half cycle of this current. Remaining half cycle is here. I will show you later. From this point to this point, we will use only one IGBT. Remaining three IGBT will remain open. Only this IGBT we will make it on and off. This red color is on period, green is off. Suppose this terminal is positive. So I will write positive here. Now at this point, we will switch on this IGBT. So I will make this IGBT on. This is on now. So how current will flow? This is positive. So current will flow like this. So circuit is complete. And current in this will start increasing. So current is increasing. At this point, we will switch off this. So I will open this. Now what happens? There is no path here for current to flow. So current will flow like this. So this current is flowing through capacitor and capacitor is charging and current here will reduce. It is reducing because this energy will transfer here. At this point, again we will switch on this. So again current will flow like this. And current here will increase. During this period, when this is on, this current will not go here, but load will draw the current. So capacitor will discharge. So capacitor is discharging. So when this IGBT is on, current in the inductor will increase, but voltage across capacitor will reduce because it will discharge from here to here. And when this is off, current in inductor will reduce. There is no path here. This current will flow like this in the capacitor. This energy will transfer here. Our current here will reduce, but capacitor voltage will increase because this energy is getting transferred to here. Like that, we'll go on making this IGBT on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, like that. So depending upon requirement, we can make it on and off as and when we want. So we can create the current wave shape as desired. And voltage here will be like this. Now we will go to negative half cycle. In negative half cycle, this will be positive. So I will write positive here. Now from this point to this point, we will not use this IGBT. We will use this IGBT. This IGBT was used for positive half cycle. This IGBT will be used for negative half cycle. At this point, I will switch on this IGBT. So IGBT is on. This is the current flowing in this. Now how current will flow? Like this. This is positive, na? So current will flow like this. So circuit is complete and current in this inductor will start increasing. At this point, we will switch off this. When we will switch off this, current which was going here cannot go now. It will go like this. It will flow through capacitor like this. Circuit is complete. So from this point to this point, this IGBT is off and this energy is getting transferred to here and capacitor is charging. So exactly same thing is happening here which was happening in the positive half cycle. So we can switch on, off as per our requirement. So here only two IGBT are sufficient to control the system. But in fact there will be four IGBT, remaining two either will not be used or sometime these two will be used or sometime these two will be used or some other combination such that heating is less. By making this IGBT on and off at very high frequency, we can bring this ripple very less. Here I have shown at very low frequency such that I can explain you. We can select switching on and off time as we want. So we can shift the whole current and we can control the power factor also. Today we will close now.